what's happening in Boston up the middle for them. When it was announced that Trevor Story would have an elbow procedure, in fact, it happened earlier this week, some fans were caught off guard by that. After all, he was the contingency plan when Bogarts walked away. What's the prognosis for recovery? What's the timeline until Red Sox fans will see him back on the field?
Matt, unfortunately for the Red Sox, the timeline is unclear. No one really knows if or when Trevor Story is going to play in Major League Baseball in 2023. That is a very disturbing headline indeed for the Boston Red Sox. The surgery was announced as an internal bracing of the UCL in his right elbow. We could, in layman's terms, call it a modified Tommy John surgery with a shorter recovery timetable. That recovery timetable could be around 6 months, but here we are in January. 6 months puts you in the middle of July, and that's if everything goes great. So we know this. Story, and you see it there, has had a number of injury issues in recent years.
You take your blood, spin it, shoot it back into the injury.
That's exactly right, Harold, and more or less. So I think that from a standpoint of Story and the Red Sox planning for this year, you have to almost consider anything from him to be a bonus and not plan on him. And the one name that I'll mention, and this is courtesy of our colleague Peter Gammons, who I think would be a tremendous fit for a short term, would be Nick Ahmed with the Arizona Diamondbacks.
Well, that doesn't make any sense.
Well, it does make some sense because Nick Ahmed is from the great state of Massachusetts and was a college baseball teammate of the current Red Sox hitting coach, Peter Fatsy. And in the case of Ahmed, he is someone that perhaps with the Diamondbacks young talent arriving could be available for a short-term deal. Here is what their club looks like at the moment. Could you have Kike play short? Obviously, based on the current personnel, that's where you'd have to go and then have Jaron Duran be the center fielder. But I think we would all look at this roster and say, this is not one that's going to be able to compete with the New York Yankees or the Rays or the newly fortified Toronto Blue Jays. The Boston Red Sox and Chaim Bloom all of a sudden on the 11th of January, gentlemen, have a lot of work to do indeed.
Oh, boy. So we're going to have Pete Abraham on the show a little bit later on. Pete has covered the Red Sox for a long time with the Boston Globe, and these are questions for Pete for sure. I know that there's been some conversation coming out of New England, great in New England, about the team desiring to get better up the middle. There's not much out there on the free agent market at this stage of the game. I'm not sure what kind of deal they think they could strike for a Nick Ahmed or somebody who's under contract elsewhere. This has really been a very interesting, and that's a diplomatic choice of words, interesting offseason for the Red Sox.
JP, I got to ask you this before we let you go, too. With the timing of this and knowing they didn't sign Bogarts and they haven't done anything up the middle, this had to have caught the Red Sox by surprise. Am I right?
Yes, and obviously when the season ended, this was not something that was on the Red Sox radar. And to the point that you made earlier, Harold, it raises a great question of depending on when exactly the Red Sox find out this information and where Correa was in his process, would they have taken a 5 or a 6 year deal with Correa for Carlos a chance to play in a major East Coast market, which is what appealed to him about the Mets? Wouldn't Correa, with his longstanding ties to Alex Cora, have been a really good fit in Boston had the Red Sox known the full extent of the Story situation? And even then, to go back to November, December, if they had known this information at that point in time, they could have taken an entirely different approach to Correa. It's an excellent question. And to me, it really illustrates that the Red Sox simply did not have full information on Story's health until probably the last several days or maybe the last couple of weeks at the very earliest.